Hi everyone, Mark Chess here. Welcome to the channel, and today I'll be giving you my first initial impression on the KYRIE 7s. Are they good? Are they bad? Let's find out. Before we start with the initial impression of the KYRIE 7, guys, I still have an ongoing raffle, so I'll be putting the details down in the description below on how to join. All the mechanics are there, so good luck and hopefully you'll win. So first up, of course, as I've discussed, if you haven't watched my unboxing, I've discussed the materials there already. So here in the video, I'll just be giving you how they perform. So let's start off with the upper of the KYRIE 7, which features a heat welded honeycomb mesh with an underlining fabric. And overall, the comfort, the feel when you first wear it, it's not stiff at all. It's very, very light on the foot. Although it's not that soft, it is still very comfortable around your foot. So nothing to worry about that. I didn't notice anything about the material when I first wear it. No stiffness. And that's kind of a surprise. The upper is more ventilated compared to the KYRIE 6 and the KYRIE 5s because it's a lot thinner. That's what I initially felt on this. And it's really, really light. Another impression. First impression that I got on the KYRIE 7. And of course, around the heel part of the upper, you will still feel that support that you need. Although I think there's more support on the KYRIE 6, but this one ain't that bad either. Still just have to really tighten up the lace until the last lace loop. And as for the heel support, it's still very nice, although it's not as big as the ones in the KYRIE 6. Like I said, if you want more support, I would go more on the KYRIE 6, but the KYRIE 7 ain't that bad either. You just need to really tighten up the last lace loop and you're good to go in terms of ankle protection and heel support. And as for heel lockdown, no problems there at all. The four fingers sound on the forefoot part, it really locks you down in the footbed, and in terms of lateral support, it also helps end containment of your foot. For the ease of wear, it has a traditional lacing system, very similar to the KYRIE 6. Very easy to put your foot in. Like I said, the weight, it's really lighter. The weight is well balanced from the forefoot to the heel. That's the main thing that I noticed on the KYRIE 6, because the KYRIE 6 has a big heel TPU plate. The weight of the sneaker is heavier on the heel. You will feel that. But when you're playing, you won't feel that much. On hand, holding it, you can really feel how light the KYRIE 7s are. It's the same material that they use on the KYRIE 6. This plastic goes up for lateral protection. What's nice about the designer of the KYRIE, they still maintain the strong spots of the KYRIE 6 and brought it to the 7s. And as for the medial side, the outsole also goes up to really cradle your foot down in the footbed. Now moving on to the cushion of the KYRIE 7. Like I said in my unboxing, it's very similar to the KYRIE 6, and the way you play it, you need to break it in a bit compared to the KYRIE 6, where you immediately feel the zoom turbo in the forefoot on the KYRIE 6. But on the KYRIE 7, you need to use it a little to soften up the phylon carrier. Then you would feel the zoom turbo in the forefoot, which is as nice as the KYRIE 6. If you like the KYRIE 6, you would surely love the KYRIE 7. And like I said, I mentioned in my unboxing that it feels a little thicker. I think it is a little bit more impact protection on the KYRIE 7 compared to the KYRIE 6. So if you like that, especially for heel impact protection, you would like the KYRIE 7. Now moving on to the traction of the KYRIE 7. So I've watched the other reviews on the KYRIE 7 and they said that the traction wasn't that good. But I've noticed in all their reviews, they were using the Hendrix colorway, which has a black outsole. So I have the Sisterwood outsole and it's not black, it's a melon tint, very similar to the LeBron 18. And what I've noticed here, I just played on a very clean court, but the traction was really, really gnarly. I don't know if that's a factor, the color of the outsole. And of course, my traction is made out of XDR rubber. So I live here in the Philippines, so the rubber is made out of XDR here in Asia. The bite is pretty consistent in all areas. I was moving laterally. I felt really quick and it felt very responsive during my play with the KYRIE 7s. And as for the rubber compound, it's really made out of XDR rubber. So it's really hard, no fraying. and even dust, but I'm playing on a clean court. Maybe I'll give you an update on it soon if I played on another dusty floor. But right now, no dust present on the outsole of the KYRIE 6. If you love the traction of the KYRIE 6, it's very similar to the KYRIE 7s. And as for the sizing of the KYRIEs, go through to size if you're a regular footer, half size up if you're a wide footer, and if you have the KYRIE 6, KYRIE 5, it's the same sizing used on the KYRIE 7. Overall, my first impression on the KYRIE 7, comparing it to the KYRIE 6 and KYRIE 5, the upper is a lot softer, less breaking time needed, more ventilation to the upper, of course, a lighter sneaker, and of course, the Zoom Turbo is really nice. The traction is on point. The fingers support really does its job. And as for the heel support, it's pretty toned down compared to the KYRIE 6. So that's my initial impression on the KYRIE 7. It is being sold at $6,400 for this sisterhood colorway. So this is the GS price. But if you buy the four limited colors, it's more expensive by $20 or $10, I think. $10, I think, sorry. Let me know what you think about the KYRIE 7, if you have them, or if you are planning to buy one. So hit me a comment down below. This has been Marches once again. Thank you for watching. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.